So, good afternoon, respected jury members, President IESR, and participants. Myself, Krishanand Tripathi. And today I am going to talk about restoration of engraved chassis number on high strength aluminium alloy surface by etching technique. So, first I will talk about identification marks. Identification mark is punching a metal deforms and compresses its surface, which results in a disturbance also known as cold working. The cold working is process in which metal is shaped below its recrystallization temperature. It is contrasted with welding, rolling, etc. Peening the metal surface like this results in a characteristic mark on a metal that can be used to make identification number on the metal surface. The pressure in turn increases the hardness and decreases the malleability and ductility of the metal. So obliteration, there are several methods which used to obliterate the vehicle identification number, such as filing or grinding, peening, center punching, drilling, and welding.
So I'm so sorry to interrupt. If you are changing your slide, we can't see it moving. Like, it's still on the first slide. Yeah, now it's moving, yes.
Okay, ma'am. So, first grinding. The original number filed away with a powder grinder, followed by polishing and then over stamping with a new number. Then, peening involves hammering the surface with a round punch to hide the number. Over stamping. The surface bearing the number is pasted or welded over the original surface. Drilling, removing the number and surrounding metal with drill. The cavity is usually filled up with a welding material. And then last, welding, surface heated with an arc welder until the metal methods. Restoration. The reliable way of restoring the obliterated mark or erased mark is by chemically etching the surface of the metal using different types of acids. This works because the compressed surface has less resistance to oxidation and as compared to the unaffected area of the metal. Since there are different metals used in vehicles, the chemicals must be selected based on the type of metal. So here I am showing chemical etching reagents, which are selected by nature of the metal. In steel, we can select ferric chloride 25 grams, concentrated HCl 25 ml, distilled water 100 ml. Same in iron, 10% solution of sulfuric acid with potassium dichromate. In copper, brass, German silver, and other copper alloys, we have to select ferric chloride 19 gram, HCl 6 ml, and water 100 ml. And in aluminium surfaces, copper chloride 200 grams, HCl 5 ml, and distilled water 1000 ml. Here I have done case study in my internship period. So in this case, the chassis number was invisible to us. As you can see here, it's not showing. So by treating this with the aluminium reagent as copper chloride 200 gram, HCl 5 ml and distilled water 1000 ml, we have restored the chassis number. It usually takes 5 minutes to 1 hour, but sometimes it may go up to 1 or 2 days also. So here you can see that restored number is clearly visible to us. That is MA7TFR864F6901691. So now, conclusion. When serial number or identification number is obliterated, the depth of altered material will be shallow. This will be around 1 mm in metals. The serial number varies with single letter or number present in the original number. In some cases, the identification number is obliterated below or erased below the depth, so no details can be restored. It is useful to identify the formation of ghost fragments, because it disappears quickly. The examiner must record all appearances via different means, like photograph or recording notes. Once the metal has been altered by stamping process, the number is lost forever.
How about that?
Now I would like to acknowledgement Dr. Ajay Sharma sir, Director SSL, Jaipur, Dr. Romema ma'am, HRD Department of Forensic Science, VGU Jaipur. I am also grateful to Dr. Mukesh Sharma, Assistant Director, Physics Division, Mr. Anshuman V. Ramani for providing me internship and guidance for the presentation. And here are my references.